control. The same is true outside the ring, especially when it comes to drinking. Staying in control means knowing to say when. So if you drink, please drink responsibly. Remember, friends know when to say when.
A message from Budweiser and Oscar De La Hoya.
This is my idea.
This is my dream.
In the last 10 years, over 6 people have taken the bull by the...
This is my chance.
This is my bread.
And blazed their own...
My chance.
This is my bread.
And blazed their own trail.
This is my life.
It's hard to say where they found their courage, but chances are they found their supplies at Office Depot. Since 1986, we've helped businesses succeed with everything from Corel's WordPerfect Suite 7 software to Newcoat inkjet cartridges and refills, all at the best prices guaranteed. Office Depot.
This is where I take care of business.
Now, with this medication, you may experience some side
effects. A giant discount drug. We know that taking medications can sometimes be confusing, but it doesn't have to be.
It's very common, and it should go away.
So, if you have a question, ask your pharmacist.
Now, before you take any of the prescriptions or medications, you might want to check with me first. And you should check your blood pressure here weekly. We'll show you how.
Because the more you know about the medications you take...
Thanks.
...the better you'll feel.
NHL hockey, the coolest game on earth, the goalie must have superhuman reflexes. His biggest challenge is the screen. Here, an offensive player attempts to obscure the netminder's vision. Of course, a clever and resourceful goalie like John Van Beesbroek can neutralize the situation quickly and efficiently.
Stay tuned next for the Capitals postgame show on WB50, immediately following the game.
Let the good times roll on WB50 at home for the Washington Capitals, trying to make it back-to-back home ice wins on the WB. 20 minutes done tonight against visiting Phoenix. Chris Simon, Michael Pivanka on the scoreboard. It's 2-0 for the locals after one. Fans, in the moments prior to tonight's game, Craig Lachlan had a chance to sit down with Mike Gartner, the longtime cap. Let's have a look and a listen to Gartner's assessment of the Coyotes and his reflections of days gone by. Craig, take it away, please.
Thanks, Joe B. Locker here with Mike Gartner, the former Capital, and obviously coming back here, Mike, some fond memories of the US Air Arena?
Always will be, Locker, playing 10 years here, going through a lot. Starting my career here as a Washington Capital, I'll always have fond memories here.
What about this team now? You guys are off to a poor start. Now you've turned it on. You've won 3 straight.
We've won 3 straight. I think we've won 9 out of our last 11 games, and we're starting to play a lot better than we were originally. And I think that we had a decent start, then we went into a real tailspin, and as of late, we've turned things around. We started to play well. We started to score some goals, which was a problem for us earlier in the year, and one that I don't think anybody would have realized out of our team that would have been a problem, but the puck is starting to go in the net, and we're starting to win some hockey games.
Now, take us back to this past summer. You're coming off a great year in Toronto, over 30 goals, led them in power plays, and all of a sudden you found out you were traded. Tell us how that happened, where it happened, how you found out.
Well, it was a little bit strange. My family and myself were vacationing, ironically, in Arizona, and we had rented a motorhome. We were traveling around California and through Arizona. We had stopped at the Grand Canyon. We thought it would be a great time to go for a helicopter ride to the Grand Canyon. We're in the hangar waiting for our helicopter to take off, and my wife went outside to try and get a paper. We hadn't read a paper in about a week. It was draft time. We figured maybe the Leafs had made some moves, and she couldn't get a paper and came back into the waiting room and just happened to be looking over the shoulder of a gentleman who was reading the front page of the sports section, the Arizona Republic, and saw the headlines, Coyotes get Gartner. So that's how I found out that I was traded to the Phoenix Coyotes. And we still went on the helicopter ride, and the Grand Canyon is still the same, by the way, Locker.
Thank you. It's still there. Well, after that, you also said that there was some talk about retirement. And how is Phoenix now, the city, taking you guys in, and do you feel very comfortable now in Phoenix?
Well, originally, the only reason I talked about retirement, it wasn't so much from the aspect of going to the Phoenix Coyotes, it was from the aspect of leaving Toronto. We had made our home in Toronto, we had started a business there, our family was well secured there, and
right.
It was really just a matter of whether I wanted to pick my family up and move again, and it was really a family decision, and once we made the decision to go to Phoenix, we've been very happy there. Our family's now comfortable, and their kids are in school, and actually the people of the Valley of the Sun have taken us under their wing and really opened us welcomed us with open arms, and it's been a great reception from the standpoint of a new team in a new city.
Now tell us about your business. I heard you're into the ice rink business, and
yes.
The ice rink's coming up in Phoenix.
Well, actually, there's none in the planning.
But you're planning one?
Well, it's in the back of our minds anyway, and we've we've got I think 9 up and running right now in British Columbia and Ontario, and we're looking to expand into the States, and Phoenix is ironically one of the places that we've had targeted.
Now, what about your family? All the Caps fans says, hey, how's Colleen? How's Mike's wife? How are the kids? Josh? Everybody?
Everybody
how's everything
is,
going?
Everybody is great. My wife, Colleen, is doing well, and Josh is 12 years old now. Natalie's 10, and I have a little boy that's 1.5. His name's Dylan. They're all hockey players, including Natalie.
Now, I heard she's a goaltender, Garth.
No, actually,
Josh is
a goaltender, and Natalie is a goal scorer. So she's taking
scorer.
After her dad, and Josh is trying to stop some pucks.
Well, Mike Gartner, thanks for being with us. Could be the last time here at US Air Arena for you, and we're happy to have you on.
Thanks, Craig.
That's it, Joe. We've got to take it to the commercial right after this. Joe B will be back with a lot more highlights from the first period right after this.
Dig the hole, dig the hole, dig the hole.
Catch the tail, catch the tail, catch the tail.
Bite the leg, bite the leg, bite the leg.
Take a lesson from the dog. Focus on the simple things and you'll be happy.
Find a fare, find a fare, find a fare.
Southwest Airlines low fares from $29 will give you the freedom to go, see, and do things more often. Just purchase your round-trip tickets by January 23rd and at least a day in advance.
Find a phone, find a phone.
Hi, I'm Adam Oates of the Boston Bruins. This is Scott, and this is Ricky. Every hockey game begins with a face-off. The key to successful face-offs is concentrating on the puck and getting your stick on it first. Keep both hands grip low on your stick and your stick flat on the ice. Glue your eyes to the puck in the ref's hand. When the ref drops it, turn your stick into the puck and snap it back to your teammate. Remember, have fun, practice hard.
What makes this Dodge Caravan such a value is our Family Value Package. For no extra charge, you get 7 passenger seating, security drawer, air conditioning, and more. Plus, you also get seats that roll, cup holders, and storage spaces, even a great stereo. All for just $17,815. But what makes this Family Value Package so valuable is where you'll find it. In America's best-selling minivan, Dodge Caravan. See the friendly Dodge dealer near you.
Season tickets, call 301-336-CAPS.
The Capitals in January on HTS. Oh yeah, it's a happy new year. 5 games featuring the best in the top. The Bruins. So far, it's still unclear who rules. This one decides. The Rangers. They've got Messier in the great one. But we've had the Broadway Blues number all season long. Plus, the rags to riches Dallas Stars. Your Capitals Happy New Year is here, all January long on HTS.
Caps 2 betters than the Coyotes after a period of play tonight at US Air Arena, out shooting the Coyotes by 2 as well, and getting some early strikes, and then watching Ole Kolzig turn in a pretty solid 20 minutes of work as well as the defense. Joe Beninati along with Craig Lachlan. Craig, we mentioned this Coyotes team was prone to gamble a little bit, and they got caught early.
Yeah, they did, especially their blue liners. I mean, you've got Tavrodosky, great skills, great speed. He's 20 years old.
Dave Manson's not afraid to jump up in the play. Teppo Newman also not afraid to jump up. These are all skilled defensemen. They like to gamble because they like to odd man rush the other team. They score a lot of goals off the initial rush. However, if you have a breakdown, that other team is going the other way with an odd man break. The Caps converted on a 2-on-1. They also converted on a dumb penalty by the Phoenix Coyotes and scored on a 4-on-3.
Mental note for the Coyotes. No dumb breakdowns when Peter Bonder is on the ice. He will make you pay, and he did with Chris Simon's help.
I certainly did. Here's some plays. Set it up in the corner here. Here we have Dallas Drake with the puck. Jeremy Roenick circling out. Watch the puck come through here. Looking for this guy right there, Teberdoski. Here's a little pass right through the seam. They're on a... Here it is. He misses it. Hold it here. Now here's Teberdoski. Now he's turning, but look at Bonder in full speed, Simon in full speed. Teppo Numminen has to get back. And here's the two-on-one play. You can see Teberdoski to the right side of the screen trying to catch Simon. And that's what Teppo Numminen's hoping. Hold it here. Here's the problem. You might as well build him a little couch. There's no reason to go down because that opens up the lane. He should have stayed up. The pass gets across and boom, Simon scores his first goal in about 5 games.
Simon on the board there. I like the furniture locker. Simon's 8th at 222. Bonder with a pickup. And it was a 1-0 for Washington.
And then we set it up here on the power play. Here's Pavonka getting it back to Housley. Typical 4-on-3 play. This Phoenix Coyotes team giving the Caps a lot of room. Hold it here. Here's the inverted triangle. Okay, working on a 4-on-3. But look at this side of the ice. It's wide open. On a 4-on-3, Joe, you've got to have your goalie come up with a stop. Hold it here. This is a bad shooting angle. He's way over here. Wachluck should be out here. He takes away the shot. It shouldn't go in. The Caps get a fortunate bounce. Pavonka on the bad angle. A soft goal by Wachluck, and the Caps lead 2-0.
Michael Pavonka on the board. His first goal since October 23. Good to have him back. And that's the way it stands. The Washington Capitals with those 2 goals in the summary column, a 2-0 lead. I can hear furniture companies calling Locker for endorsement deals. We'll have the second period after this.
Have you seen the elf? It's hiding behind this card. The elf.
The world's smallest 2x zoom camera. Very cool. The big news in the advanced photo system.
The elf. Have you seen the elf?
New from Canon.
This is my idea.
This is my dream.
In the last 10 years, over 6 million people have taken the bull by the horns.
This is my chance.
This is my break.
And blazed their own trail.
This is my life.
It's hard to say where they found their courage, but chances are they found their supplies at Office Depot. Since 1986, we've helped businesses succeed with everything from Colombian envelopes to Dr. Grip pens from Pilot. All at the best prices guaranteed. Office Depot.
This is where I take care of business.
Fresh. Fresh as the golden glow of a Sunday morning. Or the winds on the waters of the Chesapeake Bay. Fresh as the blush on a juicy Georgia peach. Or a cool breeze over sun-soaked fields. Fresh as fresh can be. Because your family deserves the very best. The freshest choice. That's Giant.
The Bullet, ready to play. Big time on WB50.
Chris Webber. Juwan Howard. The league's most dazzling front court duo. One thing for sure, they're way up there.
the bullet.
Ready to play.
Big time.
Ready to sting the Hornets right back. Saturday night at 7:30.
On WB50.
So the Washington Capitals keep the Phoenix Coyotes reeling in the first period this season. The Coyotes have had tons of trouble. They've gotten better as the game goes along. We'll see how that turns out tonight on WB50. Caps in front, 2-0. Craig, about more numbers on the Southwest Airlines staff.
Well, here we pick off. The Caps out shooting the Coyotes by 2. Scoring chances, 7 combined, 1 favoring better by the Capitals. Face-off even Stevens at 8 apiece. Power plays the Caps. That was the big power play. 4-3, 1-for-1. The Coyotes 0-for-2 as we get ready to start this second period.
Good news for the power play, too. 1-for-1. They're 2 for their last 6, including the outing against Hartford.
And it's good to get this guy going.
Yeah.
He was struggling, wasn't really finishing his checks, wasn't doing a whole lot out there. Maybe that goal has lit a fire and he's going to get it going. I saw a lot of positive things in that first period that Simon's going to get him back on track for the Caps.
He had a 2-point game in the earlier matchup between these two, a 4-3 decision for Phoenix back at America West on December 17th. Newman in, away from Bonder, and the puck winds up at Jim Schoenfeld's feet on the player's bench.
Barnsley trying to continue his goal-scoring streak. He's riding a 5-game goal streak. He's going to do it.
Don't wipe that stick. It's got a lot of magic in that stick.
I
don't want to lose any of it. Of course, wiping it down, more than likely you get ice shavings on there. Gets wet, you lose your grip.
I wish I would have known that.
That was the reason.
Thanks for telling me. You're a goaltender telling me what to do.
What the heck do I know? I've been hitting the head too much. Pivanka will draw with Roenick. Just 10 seconds into period two. Teppo Newman in. Got to be right up there with favorite names for Joe B.
What, Teppo Newman?
Teppo Newman.
I thought it was Popo Gigi. Or is it Teppo Newman?
Stop right there. Mark Tenorti. Away from Shane Doan. Mondra, bear hugged by Newman in, and it'll be Drake to clear in. Kolzig with instructions for Tenorti. Johansson keeps it moving, and Kavanka's out there and away for the catch. Along to Bondra. Peter Bondra drifting in with Tenorti. Fires, and Wakula got a chunk with a goal stick. Jeremy Roenick now back for Phoenix, 3-on-3. Roenick leans into the offensive charge, and Doan with Tkachuk offsides on the play. Fans, how about getting a group together? Family, friends, co-workers, you can all come on out and enjoy the excitement of Caps hockey. This is the number you need to write down for group ticket information. 301-336-CAPS.
Caps right after this game, off to Hartford. Rematch with the Hartford Whalers. Hartford Whalers will be out with Mr. Primo. After that slash, we'll be on HTS tomorrow night. Al Koken, my good buddy, will be joining me. And a pregame show, 6:30. Locker's going to be there at about 7, right when the game starts. But Al Koken will be here on HTS at 6:30. So
step by
I'm going to meet you at 7.
Step by step all the way through. Miller in the offensive end. Deep slot swung. Eagles had it all cocked and ready to shoot. Never got the puck. Klee will clear it in. We get a whistle. And the dump in from center. Washington was ruled offside.
Got a couple of the leading scorers around the National Hockey League in action here tonight in Landover. You obviously have Tkachuk, fourth overall, 24 goals. You also have Peter Bonder right up there closing in. There you take a look at the all-time goal leaders in Caps history. Look at Mike Gartner, 397 goals, 758 games. Mike Ridley, 218. You're going to see Bondra pass Mike Ridley this year, and that's Locker's bet of the night right there, that Peter Bondra's going to get more than 9 goals.
He's a lock. Yeah. In fact, Bondra, that ratio there, pretty effective.
Very effective.
So Van Kotek did not clear first attempt. Phil Housley on the second try. Peters back and uses the goal net for some leverage. Way down with Darren Quint. He handed it right to Housley. Out comes Konowalczyk. Shannon got in the way, and Cote will flip back to center. Yogi Svejkovski, just summoned from American Hockey League Portland. On for the injured Joey Juneau, and also for the scratched Jason Allison. Puck dumped deep. Jim Johnson with a touch-up, and this will come all the way back, icing against the Caps.
Well, Joe B., there we get the first look at the Phoenix Coyotes jersey. The lock man says, I like it. It's a fashion statement. I like it. And we're going to have a little poll being taken up here throughout the press room. We're going to show the fans later on in the game. Obviously, the only important vote is mine, but we'll also have other votes along with that. We'll give you an opportunity. Our good buddy, our AD, Larry Getlin, may get an opportunity, a half a vote. And anybody else downstairs, forget it. It's the Lockman show, and I'm going to decide if they're nice or not.
You realize
the problem is, Joe, you know why I think they're nice?
Go ahead.
I'm colorblind.
That would be it.
So there you
go. That would be it.
I don't even know what color it is. I'm colorblind,
well,
but I like the design.
Craig, they got everything in there. Black, jade, purple. Ugh.
I like them.
Ugh, colorblind. That's what you are. And you're also really self-centered. You don't let anybody's vote count. Ronan knocked down by Simon. 2-0. Caps have the advantage on the visiting Phoenix Coyotes. Fashion statement or no. Dallas Drake trying to worm his way out of the corner. Johansson pinched him to the boards. Kinnorty's long reach trying to spirit that puck loose. Jeremy Roenick there in hot pursuit. Chris Simon, long hair flowing, comes out of there with it. A rink-wide deal. Bondra plays the corner. Doan avoids Simon's forecheck. Ivanka on the takeaway. Cote. Wrist shot blocked by the sprawling Drake. Simon has it behind the net. Simon gets one for Pivanka. Bang, a shot caught the side of the goal, and Wakaluk is quick to pounce.
See, all of a sudden you score a goal, and all of a sudden you feel energized. It's a big load on your shoulders when you're not producing, you're not scoring. It's a real downer. Now that Chris Simon scored a goal, now all of a sudden he's bopping around out there. He's the first man in forechecking. Everything seems to come off your shoulders. You're more relaxed. You're playing with confidence. Big improvement in Chris Simon, the way he's played this first two periods.
And ditto for Michael Pivanka, who got a goal, and this is his 11th game since returning to the lineup from that bad knee injury.
There's Anson Carter. Yeah, they're looking for some goals from him. Having a pretty good camp down in the American Hockey League. Playing very well. 14 goals, 15 assists, 29 points. They'd like to put them in the NHL, those types of numbers.
I know you like his speed. Carter, a very good skater who likes to slash to the open spaces. Mike Eastwood, more of a burly center ice when he'll clear it in. Kolzig handles that clearing attempt. Keith Tkachuk sidesteps Housley. Got doubled by Cote, and the Caps have the puck. Berube thumped by King. Anson Carter didn't get it out. King turns one right on, and that's blockered down. Anson Carter moves Washington to neutral ice. Carter on the run. With Berube, a bouncing puck foiled him. Here's the counterattack. Tkachuk moving in. Tkachuk, and back behind the play, Chris King has it going with Kevin Kaminsky.
And that all started in the neutral zone. King took exception to the fact that Kaminsky finishes his check and knocked them flying. These two guys going at it. There's a couple of shots at the end. Killer Kaminsky and King, two tough customers. A little fracas here as the play's going up the other end. Joe, I have to tap you on the shoulder. Little fight down at the other end. We're going to have coincidental majors. 2-0 Caps here on WB. We'll be right back.
Shoe size 19E. If you think they're hard to fill, imagine what it takes to fill the rest of him. Well, new cheese tortellini from Chunky puts the bill. It's loaded with giant ring-shaped pasta stuffed with cheese, plus huge chunks of chicken and tons of vegetables. So if you've got a giant appetite to feed, Campbell's Chunky scores with the big boys. Satisfied?
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought so. Campbell's Chunky, soup that eats like a meal.
Hard Rock Cafe. Hot food, great music, and the largest collection of rock memorabilia. So whether you're wearing biker black or red, white, and blue, you'll feel right at home at the Hard Rock Cafe.
College basketball on HTS. Ready to get crazy. Ready to play. West Virginia, UConn, Saturday at noon. Notre Dame and Rutgers, Saturday at 2. Only on HTS. Ready to play. The Capitol. Ready to play on WB50.
Glad you've joined us tonight for Capitals Hockey on WB50. Tomorrow, the action swings over to home team sports, HTS, as the Caps rematch with the Hartford Whalers. 7 o'clock's the face-off time. It all gets underway. Coverage does with the pregame show, the Capitals Report, at 6:30. Al Koken alongside Craig Lachlan for that one.
Little shopping action maybe tomorrow,
in
right?
In the mall, in the insurance
little shopping
city.
Action tomorrow.
Really good candy store. Really good candy store in that mall for those of you who are going to be visiting anytime soon. Jim Schoenfeld will be there, and I'm sure he'll go down for a couple of coconut haystacks or two.
Coconut haystack?
Ron Weber's favorite. I have to... No, never mind. Never mind. Janney out there with Corkum and McKenzie. We go five aside. There are coincidental majors doled out to King and Kaminsky. That will not change the manpower strength. 2-0. Washington with the lead. All the scoring back in the first. Simon trickles it to the wing. Bondra will not get there. Newman does. Cote taps and Roenick advances. No more. McKenzie with Simon trying to fidget that puck through. A lot of work along the dasher boards tonight. McKenzie angled there by Cote. Pivanka swoops in the steal. And clear. Teppo Newman handed it right to Chris Simon. Waits for Bondra to tag up so the offside will not come into effect. But Doan picked his pocket and dumps it back into the defensive end. Pulls it crisply for Simon. He didn't get clear. Housley darts away from McKenzie. Doan, stick check by Cote. Check that. That was Kenny Cleon for Cote. And back out to center we go. A delayed minor penalty coming up. It's going to come against the Caps. As the pass is picked up at center by Klee, apparently big Chris Simon has committed an infraction.
Yeah, you see, Chris Simon likes those jerseys, too. He's trying to get a big hunk of that in his glove, and that's why he was nailed right in the neutral zone. Tverdovsky, watch this, at the right side of the screen. Watch Chris Simon's left hand. See, he wants to take one of those jerseys home. He loves it, but he gets caught. He's in the box holding. There he is, going for a little sleigh ride, and he gets caught as Tverdovsky falls, and that big mitt caught right on the jersey. He's off in the box.
Tverdovsky's sweater won't fit him, Craig. He needs to try and rip off McKenzie.
He wants to hang it up.
He needs to get McKenzie's or Wakaluk's maybe, one of those big 60 goalie cuts. That's the only one that's going to fit him. That sweater might fit Simon, not Tverdovsky. 15:22 to go in period two. It's 2-0 Washington. Simon and Pavanka on the board back in the opening frame. Here's a power play now for Phoenix. We have it unofficially as their third of the night. Tkachuk, Ronning, Gartner up top. Quint and Tverdovsky will shoot away from the points. Tverdovsky, the 20-year-old second-year pro. Number two player selected back in the 94. Jovanovski went first. Here's a steal. Kelly Miller working back. Miller, stick check, caught from behind by Ronnie. Oleg Tverdovsky, Russian-born. Flips right to Mark Tenorti. Tenorti, back checked by Gartner. This is Tkachuk. Tkachuk, Christian caught the skate of Eagles and deflected wide. Johansson plays to his partner Tenorti with room. Tenorti taps and Eagles will play clear. Eagles drifting into the offensive end. Caps in the middle of changing their penalty killers. Nice work by Eagles to lug it in there deep. Konowalczuk trots after it in the corner. Worked over from behind by Tverdovsky. Ronning trying to play free and Konowalczuk spins it back behind the Phoenix net. Power play time for the Coyotes quickly down to 54 seconds. 14:15 to go in the second period. It's 2-0 Washington. Working shorthanded, leaves it back behind the net. Great work by the shorthanded cap. Konowalczuk ducks away from Quint. Hits Nikolishin. And he'll play to the vacant corner. And an appreciative crowd at USA Arena responds to a nice game of keep away.
That was just awesome. Penalty kill. That's the best we've seen in a long, long time. Gee, Coyotes might want to decline the power play next time if the Caps continue to play like that.
Bolzik dribbles one off for Riki, and Riki will blast it by Manson. Just 16 seconds in this Coyotes power play, number three on the night, and they've gone shotless in the first minute, 50 seconds. Janney with Roenick darting to the cage. Janney picks up Manson, big blast, locked down by Pivanka. Bondra's away to the races. Peter Bondra in solo. Bondra keeps himself wide of the shooting angle. Bondra comes in on those breakaways with such speed, he deked himself off the end.
That's a typical play where he goes to the right spots and tries to slide it into the empty net. Everything went perfect, but that one extra deep threw him off kilter a little bit, and no way Janney was going to catch him. You could see Janney huffing and puffing, but he was already about 10 strides past him. Great burst of speed by Bondra.
My word, is he explosive. Bonder sent it right to the skate boots of Mike Eastwood. He'll play clear. This is Darren Shannon working in the offensive attack. Shannon was knocked down by Sylvain Cote and Joe Rupi in combination. Caps are back to full strength. Five aside we go. 2-0. Washington in front. 12:37 to play in the second. Rupi heaves it along the boards, and Berube will skate after Jim Johnson. Johnson went as far as the center stripe. Berube will play back in, and Jeff Finley will get it. The 10th year pro, Finley swings. Took a whack in the midsection from Berube. Plays the backhand all the way down. Linesman Kevin Collins says no icing. Johansson. Outlet to Tenorti. Tenorti crushed by Kachuk. Tenorti will leave it to the wing. And Kachuk will peel back to play. Heath Kachuk riding a four-game goal-scoring streak for these Coyotes. Finley sends one in there deep. Touched up by Tenorti. This is icing. 11 minutes, 52 seconds to go in the middle frame. The Caps still protecting a two-goal cushion.
Dodge Stratus and Dodge Ram have just received the prestigious J.D. Power & Associates Appeal Award. Stratus tied for most appealing entry midsize car, and Ram receiving the award for the second year in a row as most appealing full-size pickup. The Appeal Award comes from the most knowledgeable automotive experts of all, consumers. Frankly, we're tickled. See the friendly Dodge dealer near you.
Season tickets, call 301-336-CAP.
The Coyotes with a turnover. Watch this play. Janney's got the puck. This is to Manson, and watch the deflection off Pavonka's leg. It stings, but look at Bonder off to the races. There's his patented move, the stop and start. Here's a great view at it. All-star Peter Bonder to the net. He'll go to the right, then stop, and then come back to the left. He had the goalie beat. Wachluck was down and out. That one little extra move at the end caused Bonder to lose that biscuit and an opportunity to continue his goal-scoring streak.
Real good work by our WB50 crew tonight in Landover. Bill Bell producing and directing the bunch. Top-notch as always. 11:52 to go in the second. It is 2-0 Caps. Freaky drive. That one right to the chest of the captain, Keith Kachuk. Finley out of there for the Coyotes. Kachuk stalled by Rupi. He goes, hits Hunter. Dale Hunter with a seam, perhaps. Closed off by Manson. And Finley will wait. Forced deeper by Miller. Along the glass, Ken Flea with a nice peek. Manson will deal back to center. McKenzie. Skies one towards Colgate. He traps it with a big goal stick. Rupi. Bear hugging the Coyote at the end board. Allow Eagles to play and get it clear. A multi-hopper that will slide wide of Wachluck and result in icing when Jim Johnson makes a touch-up. 2-0 Caps with 11:03 to play tonight. Fans, it's not too late to think season tickets for this year's Washington Capitals. Get your season tickets this year. You'll have priority next year when the club shifts to MCI Center. Phone number 301-336-CAPS for information on season tickets.
And Joe B., it's so amazing how that first period just clipped along. We take a look at the shots, however. We're just about halfway through the second period. There's only been one shot on net, and that's by the Coyotes. The Capitals have yet to register a shot. They had 11 shots in the first period by 11 different players. This period, nobody's able to connect against Wachluck close to 9 minutes in. Maybe the Coyotes reversing more, playing in the shell a little more. The Capitals have to get that spunk back and get some more shots on net here.
As they try to work for a win themselves, win number 17, and a win for Ole Kolzik, personal victory number 5 on the year. Cliff Ronning. Skeeters one in. Quick with a rip shot. Kolzik challenged right on top of his crease there. Ronning. Very elusive. Ronning to the goal mouth. His chance denied by Kolzig as he flashed the pad.
Great save by Kolzig with that big right leg. One of those pads just about the same size as Chris Rock.
Or me, for that matter. I thought you were going to go with
me. No, they're bigger than you.
Oh, shoot. You set myself up. Kanawalchuk away from Ronning, the diminutive one. Kanawalchuk being drafted by Ronning. Mika Leishin points it for Cote. Wrist shot deflected away from the cage. Kanawalchuk hunting for that puck. He's got it. He's Kanawalchuk, the hero of New Year's Day. Kanawalchuk with room. Pulls the trigger. That was blocked. Makovsky was dumped by Johnson. No call from referee Don Van Massenholder. Little head and shoulder fake. Mika Leishin trying to spot Kanawalchuk. Persistent pressure now from the cat. Ronan, tail end of his line shift. Didn't get it by Bondra. Bondra low bridges Van Massenholder, who stands 6'6". Quint plays the center. Just past the game's regulation midpoint. Washington with a two-goal lead. Bondra blew by Roenick. Quint stepped up and Roenick got the puck back. Darren Shannon golfs one ahead. Mike Gartner picks it up on the run, and Housley got his body in the way. Chris Simon for the cap. Dumps one cross corner. Bondra beaten to the puck by Teppo Newman, and Shane Doan, a second year pro at the tender age of 20, clears the center. Ricky waits. Rips one right into the backside of Doan. Styles one ahead. Teppo Newman had the skates taken out from under him. Here comes Pivaka. Wraparound pass for Simon. Simon didn't pull the trigger. Drake off to Jeremy Roenick. Roenick leaves it on the wing for Dallas Drake. Sliding into position. Drake tried to slot one for Doan. Well defended. End to end we go. Bondra in solo. Peter Bondra. Stopped by Wakala.
Again, the same move. He had Wakala down and out. That play usually pays off. That one hits the pad. He didn't get it up. Another chance for Bonsai to put the biscuit in the basket is denied by that Phoenix goaltender.
Big save for Darcy Wakaluk as he robbed the Caps All-Star representation center screen.
What they do is simple. So simple it would be easy to miss it altogether. But they're making a difference. You see, drunk driving fatalities are down 35% in the last 13 years, and fatalities from teen drunk driving are down 67%. So to everyone who checks an ID, offers to call a cab, or helps a customer know when to say when, we extend our thanks. By doing what's right, you are making things better. A message from Budweiser.
The Caps lead 2-0 here in WB. It should be about 4-0. Bondra with two breakaways. Here's the quick transition. Looking for Vonka. Straight to Bondra. This is full speed. Same move again right there in Wakala. That big red pad making a nice save. This, fans, is actually in slow motion. It looks full speed to me, but that was slow-mo again. Here it is. Look at Peter Bondra. He's moving faster than most skaters do, and he's in slow motion there. Nice little save, that right pad by Wakala.
Nice acrobatics, 2-0 Caps here. Elsewhere in the Giant out-of-town scoreboard, Mike Modano has added a goal for the Dallas Stars, a 2-0 leader on Detroit. St. Louis is in front. Jeff Cortnell has the only strike in that one. Martin Brodeur and Damian Rhodes throwing goose eggs at each other, New Jersey and Ottawa. Page 2, Anaheim and Tampa Bay tied up at 2 in the middle period. Toronto and Edmonton, a little over a half hour away at the Northlands Coliseum.
Tampa Bay coming back.
Yes, sir.
Dino, a goal in the second. They're right back in that hockey game after trailing 2-0.
Got a look at Peter Bondra on the bench. I bet you next breakaway he shoots, Craig. He's gone to the deke twice and foiled once by the net, foiled once by the pad of Wakala. Keith Tkachuk rumbling in. Tkachuk kept at stick's length by Johansson. Tkachuk spun around and down. Corkum points it. Finley's wrister well off the mark. Manson plays the corner for Tenorti. Tkachuk, Tenorti, Corkum, and Hunter all behind Kolzig. Centering feed in tight, and Kolzig made a key stop there on Craig Janney. Eagles will play clear.
It's amazing how a couple of saves by your goaltender inspires you on the bench. They think they're really still back in this game. Had Bondra scored in one of those breakaways, this game would have been over.
The previous matchup, Wakaluk made three super saves to start the third period. At the time the Coyotes were down by one, they ripped off three goals in succession as a result of their fine goalie's work. Johansson off to Hunter. Kaminsky gloves one down. Plays it as far as Jim Johnson. Johnson's dump in from center, catches a teammate offside. The killer. I mean, the man is an angel off the ice. But on the ice, once that chin strap gets
snarly.
Snapped,
oh, snarly.
Look out.
Bolzig's been solid. Faced 13 shots, stopped everyone. Here's a little play behind the net. Look at Janney getting that high scoring area. Sneaks in, very quietly gets into the zone without anybody spotting him. There he gets back. Good save. Kolzig stands up. That's when he's at his best, when he's not flopping around. When he stands up, uses his size to his advantage. There, stopping that point-blank shot from Janney.
Phoenix has a shots on goal lead, 13-12. Washington has a scoreboard lead, 2-0. Simon and Pavaka, the goal-getters, in period one. Jim Johnson, who patrolled the Caps blue line here for a couple of seasons plus, gave it right to Kevin Kaminsky. Kaminsky, shadowed by Quint. Anson Carter, pirouettes away from Eastwood. Berube on the overlap, tripped down by Johnson, play continued. Quint shovels it ahead. And it'll be Chris King, one-handed to center. Sylvain Côté. His pass didn't find Berube, and the Caps will do it all over again as Kaminsky needs to be separated from McKenzie. Housley, outlet, Nikolishin tap. Spakovsky just off the player's bench. Got a bear hug onto Manson. Coyotes, Dallas Drake in hot pursuit of Phil Housley. He'll spin it back to center, and Manson will reload. Finley off for Drake, and Côté was writing hurt on him. Roenick spun around. Drake working wide from a bad angle, and Kolzig had that stick and pad right pinned to the post. 3-on-3. Nikolishin back for the cap. Kind of Welchuk splits the gap. Rogue one in on Wachlak, who had the paddle down. Back comes Jeremy Roenick. Roenick waiting for some help. Gliding in, and as he did so, he's offside on the play.
Some good end-to-end action here on the WB 545 left here in the second. Couple of chances both ways. Here's Andre Nikolishin, 3-on-3. Look at him, a little chip pass to Cano. Look at that nifty move around Manson, and he has to come up a save. Wachlak sticking that stick out there. Look at this great view right here. Nice little nifty dish pass. Look at Cano Walchuk, outside, inside, between the two defenders. At the end, he just doesn't get his stick on it as he's taken out by Jeff Finley. But good work by the Caps. They're skating to the net. That was the key for Cano Walchuk.
Fans, Saturday night at 6, will Maeve become an evil sculptor's masterpiece? Find out on The Adventures of Sinbad, Saturday night at 6, right here on WB50.
I don't know, will he? What do you think?
It's too deep a question for me. I'm still stuck on the do you like the Coyotes jersey question.
There's Cliff Ronnie. There it is again. There's Cliff Ronnie.
What's going on with the neck collar? What is that, trimming?
I know.
Oh, I just don't know.
We got some results here, too, Joe B.
We do. We've taken a poll of our crew, our announcers.
There it is.
And?
Like 58%, 14, dislike 42%, 10. So that means there was 24 people asked that question.
Are all the precincts reporting? We have the final result. I want to revote. Inside a chance for Darren Shanney, drifted it wide. 2-0. The Caps and the Coyotes in their funky uniform.
And you know, when I mentioned that, maybe I shouldn't have said that Locker wanted it to win, because a lot of people follow.
you little pollster, you, an opinion setter. Chris Simon lost it to the battle there of Tverdovsky. Tenorti way up to give Gartner a thump. Oleg Tverdovsky lays it out. Ronning on the run. This is a 3-on-2 if they kick it. Gartner working wide. Ronning cutting in. Pavalka got back. No numbers advantage. Dalio Hoxha without his hockey stick, trying to play with his left hand ahead. You're allowed to make a hand pass in the defensive zone, and Eagles plays through. Newman in for Phoenix. Ronning, poke check. Ronning, wrist shot blocked down. In there, tight. Horkum digging for the loose puck, and Peter Bonder snares it for Washington's Capitals. Hunter, out of a pack, with a puck. Hunter will play it in there deep. Bonder was spun around and down behind the play. Power play coming for the Washington Capitals. Dale Hunter barking his approval at the call, perhaps. 2-0, Washington with a lead in the manpower when we return.
for the gold. The new Rebel G. Get the ultimate rush.
Shoe size 19E. If you think they're hard to fill, imagine what it takes to fill the rest of him. Well, new cheese tortellini from Chunky puts the bill. It's loaded with giant ring-shaped pasta stuffed with cheese, plus huge chunks of chicken and tons of vegetables. So if you've got a giant appetite to feed, Campbell's Chunky scores with the big boys. Satisfied?
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought so. Campbell's Chunky, soup that eats like a meal.
Caps fans, if you can't make it to each and every home game remaining on the schedule in 97, you may want to try the 10-game pack. It's the Caps Ice Pack. 11 games for the price of 10. A Rangers game for free. 301-336. Caps is the number to call.
Well, when you're not used to this style of game, the Phoenix Roadrunners, a team that like to run and gun. There we take a look at Bob Cork and having a seat in the penalty box. He hooked down Mike Eagles in the neutral zone. He's off in the box. That's a sign of frustration. He wasn't moving his feet. He's frustrated. It's not very fun playing against the Washington Capitals. And every team around the NHL knows that because they're in your face. They finish their checks. They do all the things you don't like to do. They hook, they hold. You can just see the frustrations on this Coyote team when they're on the ice. Ronning's throwing his stick. He's getting upset. Kachuk can't break through. It's frustrating, and it's the Caps are working their magic. This is Caps hockey.
Two of Jim Schoenfeld's favorite adjectives to describe that play, aggressive and abrasive. This particular guy, I don't think he minds aggressive and abrasive play because he dishes it out as well as he receives it. Keith Kachuk, penalty killing now for the Coyotes. Washington's got its second manpower advantage of the night. They struck on a 4-on-3 power play. Michael Pivanka back in the first. They are two for their last six. Housley trying to finesse his way away from Kachuk. Kachuk dumped him and heads to the bench for the shift change. Housley motors back. Nikolishin. Rink wide for Dale Hunter. The corner now, Konowalczuk. Kote blocked off Eastwood. Or check that, Gartner with a steal. Mike Gartner slipped for the aforementioned Eastwood block. Here comes Konowalczuk rumbling back. Nikolishin. Drop pass to Hunter. Return to Nikolishin. Load fires right to the belly of Wakula. Nikolishin's pass shunted away by Manson. That gives enough room for Chris King to play back. King for the Coyotes. Gartner offsides on the rush.
Trying to create something out of nothing. You have Mike Gartner and Chris King coming down on a 2-on-2. And at the end of that play, you'll see Mike Gartner lift up his skate blade. That forced him offside. Therefore, the faceoff outside. The Coyotes trying to be very aggressive in this penalty-killing situation. 59 seconds left in their player's penalty, Bob Corkum.
Special team situation for Phoenix. Roenick right there in the middle of your screen with Drake, a penalty-killing forward. Teppo Newman in and back with Oleg Tverdovsky. Power play for the Caps. Pivanka, Bondra, Simon, Johansson, and Housley.
And how about that big deal, the Roenick-Jamnoff deal? Goes into Chi-Town last night. Jamnoff not performing very well either. Only 9 goals for Alexei Jamnoff. And the Chicago Blackhawks are reeling. They had a tough time winning. Phoenix goes in and beats them last night. Even though Roenick didn't do anything, they came away with an important 2 points last night.
Jeremy Roenick during the summer was courted by a number of clubs, including these Washington Capitals. They would have loved to have seen Roenick in the lineup here. He was a Group 2 free agent. His rights were eventually traded, as Craig mentioned, for Jamnoff, Craig Mills, and the number one pick. And then Roenick had some time getting into the lineup with a contract squad. Newman in. Plays it ahead for Tverdovsky. This guy, a forward or a defender? Right on into the front. Kolzig was able to move across with him.
Even more impressive, they're penalty killing.
Yeah, that's right. Told you the kid would gamble. Simon working in. Puck from behind by Dallas Drake. Drake stripped by Housley. Delayed penalty coming up. And Chris Simon got the stick up on Jeremy Roenick.
Came a shot to the head. Chris Simon picks up the initial penalty. Van Nassehoven forcing everybody away. We'll see if Simon got away with the second shot to the head. Roenick came in, and he got a little punch to the head. They're going to have to see right now how they sort this out. I think it's going to be 2 minutes for interference. He's not going to nail him for that extra punch at the end of that play.
I really don't want that big man ever to get mad at me. He is frightening.
Here it is right along the boards here. Here's the big hit coming right there. Dallas Drake interference. He's already passed the puck. And then watch as Roenick comes into the side. You'll see that big left hand come up. Look at him just minding his own business. And then boom. Sorry, Chris. It was your right hand. I said left. Here's Tvrdoski jumping up in the play. They're all start forcing the defenseman scoring. Good opportunity. You see that great speed that he has. And then he's the first man back to boot. Goes right around Phil Housley. Nice forward positioning there. This guy's a player. Uses his body, uses his leg to shield the puck. Gets a quality opportunity shorthanded against Kolzer.
Trying to make some comparisons for Tvrdoski around some of the other younger players in the league.
And you know,
Brian,
the one guy?
Brian Berard comes to mind, but I think he might even be more explosive than Berard.
I think he is, too.
Go ahead. Who came to mind for you?
Well, to me, it reminds me a lot of Phil Housley. I mean, very similar. Similar in stature. I mean, they jump up in the play. Phil Housley now a little more composed. He's getting up there in age. You know, he's more composed. Yeah. He notes the game better. This guy, a young guy, still 20 years old.
Yeah. Very long stride. That might be the biggest difference between Tvrdoski and Housley. Gartner working in. Sets up Ronnie. One-timer. Lowbridge calls it. Power play time for the Phoenix Coyotes. They trail by a deuce. 2:10 to go, second period. Manson loads it up for Ronning. Miller with a stick in the passing lane. Ronning very patient. Points it to Manson. Stick check by Kelly Miller. That's the stick in the passing lane. That's what it does for you. Teppo Newman in. Ninth year pro. Gartner will flip in. Johansson flutters one ahead. Didn't get it by Gartner. Ronning once more playing catch with Manson. Teppo Newman, his point drive blocked by Eagles. Eagles, can he clear? He does.
The top two forwards doing a great job. Kelly Miller and Mike Eagles keeping the stick in the passing lane, intercepting those passes, forcing the Phoenix Coyotes to always regroup. They're having a real tough time gaining the Capitals' blue line. That's a good sign if your penalty's going.
2-0 Washington as Miller clivers in deep. 80 seconds to go in the second period. You see the power play time left for Phoenix. On power play chance number 4. Quint will clear it in. Kachuk sent it right to Joe Rieke. Rieke in proper position to clear. There's a nice level look at Darren Quint. To a curling Dallas Drake. Now on to Jeremy Roenick. The return for Drake and Kolzer anticipated well. He'll clear it himself.
And that's what I said at the top of the show. Kolzer's going to have to be active in the net. He's got to work his stick. He's excellent with the puck.
Nicolici with a steal behind the defense. Robbed by Wakalak.
Wakalak scoring on Wakalak.
Simon put the kabong onto Ronning, and Ronning remains down on the ice. Right out of the penalty bench, Chris Simon with a heavy hit. And if I'm not mistaken, that's Cliff Ronning. I may be mistaken. It's 15. Craig Janney is who it is. So it is Craig Janney down in a heap. And Chris Simon.
He's just going to the bench.
Oh, yeah. He's going to try and get away. And hopefully with no penalty from referee Van Mazenholt.
See, the big fella's been a factor. He has to do this. He's got to kabong guys. He's got to smack guys around because Phoenix don't like it one bit as Jenny's still being looked at.
Really jawing with the corner of the bench. If we can get the Coyotes bench, Jim McKenzie
here
really
check out
some
the
luck.
Right side. Here comes big Chris Simon. Boom, right there, knocks him flat. That if Masselhoven picks that up, that's an interference minor because the puck wasn't even near there. But he's saying that was coincidental contact in the neutral zone. Chris Simon may get away with one here.
Put the shoulder right onto Janney's jaw. Craig Janney now up to his knees. Chris Simon looking across the way. Simon was getting a lecture from McKenzie, a big tough guy for the Phoenix Coyotes from their players' bench. There's Chris Simon discussing things with the referee.
But do you see a lot of other guys coming out and going after Simon?
No.
Is there the whole bench coming out? No.
That would be very, very unfortunate of him.
Here's one more look while we have this little scrum in the neutral zone here in Landover, US Air Arena. Check out the right side of the screen. Craig Janney, number 15. Chris Simon out of the box. Kaboom! And there's the puck coming to Drake. Janney's going to head off to the bench. And here's the play as it ends up here. You can see Rona come flying in. I said he was a real feisty guy for his size. Not very big. Only weighs about 190 soaking wet. He can move. He's very feisty. Always picks up the penalty minutes. But look at Chris Simon. There's the coaches over there. Paul McClain trying to plead his case for an interference minor, but I don't think the referee's going to have it. We'll have some five-on-five hockey the last 34 seconds.
Janney had his head turned and really glided into the skating lane for Chris Simon just coming out of the penalty bench.
No. Simon got away with what? If you watch the replay, he lowered his shoulder and gave him a shot. But if you get away with it, good for you, because if you're not cheating, you're not trying. And that's from my good buddy Dale Hunter. That's his favorite saying. One more look. Now watch his left shoulder. Watch this. He sees Janney. Then watch this. I don't know. He's got that up a little bit.
My comment is the puck is being passed to Janney. And I think Simon was trying to make a hit like a defensive back on a, on a wide receiver right as the puck was arriving. Janney was looking for the puck.
Anyway, you slice it. I like the way he's playing.
Oh, yeah.
Okay?
Got to be a physical
threat. Even if you don't agree with me for the first time.
I hear you. We're going to get penalties now because Joe Riecke wants to go with Jim McKenzie, and they have the gloves gone. McKenzie wanted a piece of someone. The guy he wanted is Chris Simon. And we'll see how referee Van Massenhoven rules this, because Jim Schoenfeld believes that it should be McKenzie getting the additional time. McKenzie and Riecke being escorted to the dressing room runway. With just 25 seconds left to go in the middle period, Craig, might as well get those two big boys off. Van Massenhoven at the players, rather at the referee's crease, discussing things with Dale Hunter. Well, we were flying right along, Craig, in this middle period, and now we've had a couple of stoppages in succession.
Check out this. Here's Big McKenzie right here with Kenny Clay. A little facial right there, again with that left paw on the face. In comes Joe Riecke. I think we're going to have coincidental penalties here. Here's the play as the play comes up the ice. Kaminsky trying to move the puck.
Wow. McKenzie got two rough and a five fight. Now, the question is, does Riecke get anything? Two for roughing.
Half for the five-minute major.
Wow. Play. Oh, is that not Don Hay happy at all? McKenzie got two for roughing. That matches Riecke's minor for roughing, but a five-minute additional major. Referee Van Massenhoven hit it right on the head. And as I looked across the way, Jim Schoenfeld was clapping on the player's bench, behind the player's bench, because he thought, he felt Van Massenhoven had seen it correctly. And Jim Schoenfeld was
he was out there for one
predicting
reason, and that's what the referee picked out. Yep. As we had that little scrum ensue with Simon throwing it, and then as soon as the puck was faced off, out comes McKenzie. So the referee's already got his eye on him, picked it up perfectly with the first incident with Clay. Now the Capitals go to a five-minute major power
play. So this is another major power play, unlimited goal scoring, all that, just like the Caps had after Primo slashed Juno on New Year's Day. 16, now 15 in the period. Hunter with a late charge. Cross ice, Cote. Drive! That went right into Darren Shannon's shin pads, and Shannon will bounce one clear. Look at it hop on the ice surface late in the period. Housie will stay right there, and the second period is done. 40 minutes in the books. Ole Kolzig still protecting a 2-0 lead. This time, after 40 minutes worth of work, a scoreless second. Peter Bonder had some breakaway chances. The Caps had other opportunities, and Darcy Wakaluk made some fine saves. Don Hay and the Coyotes file off to the dressing room to talk this over. We step out to commercial break. Our second intermission will be upcoming from U.S. Air Arena. Craig will have a look at highlights. We'll look at all the out-of-town scoreboard, and we'll also have a peek at more NHL. Coolest game on earth, sights and sounds, music, videos when we're back.